So all of our potting mixes are made using various materials. It's more of a traditional material method. We don't use commercial mixes, generally speaking. We're mixing our own to spec according to the plants that we are planting. So this is shale that we harvest from basically from down along the driveway from cliffs that erode every winter time from the freeze-thaw process. So we have basically an inexhaustible supply of this stuff, the shale, and we put it into greater or lesser degrees depending on the plant. For a lot of our plants that grow in shale barrens, we'll actually use quite a lot of this, if not even almost straight shale. So we use that. And then this is pine bark. And pine bark is a byproduct of the lumber and papering industry in the Carolinas. And also in Canada and Michigan. You know, it's a traditional medium for growing a lot of things in. All right, so this is a leaf humus. There's a couple of places here on the property. There were old sawmills from back in the, 30s or something like that.
1930s.
And basically, huge piles of the refuse from the sawmill were built up and over almost 100 years have degraded into this very, very rich material, which we basically go out to the old, you know, the sawmill's long gone and ruined and disappeared. But the piles were left behind, and you can basically harvest this stuff, you know, till the cows come home. And it's a really, really good, rich additive, organic additive. We also have peat, well, though some you can also just use this straight. Now, peat is kind of controversial to some extent because its sustainability in some cases, depending on where it comes from, is in question. A lot of nurseries are switching to coir, which is a coconut product, byproduct. And we may do that too at some point, but at the moment we still use, we do use peat still.
For certain plants.
Yeah. What else? Oh, here's some charcoal. That's another thing that we will frequently add. We actually make charcoal here, and we'll crush it and add it to the mix as a, you know, organic carbon. And rice hulls make a really good amendment too. They're very light and fluffy and can add a lot of drainage to the soil without adding weight. And some people think they actually produce better root growth. Perlite is the traditional potting medium. And this is a mined material. Both of these products are used to improve the drainage of the soil mix. And I will use one or the other in different measures. Perlite I'll use more in things that really need a coarse drainage over a longer period of time, plants that are going to sit around the nursery for probably a few years. Because rice hulls, after about 2 or 3 years, their porosity actually disappears. So they're great initially, and they're great for using in fast turnaround plants, but the porosity actually become wet, they begin to rot, and they flatten, and the porosity goes way down. All right, so compost is a major component of our planting mixes also. And sometimes we use that woods humus that we were talking, I showed you earlier. But in the majority of cases, we make use this homemade leaf compost. So what this is actually a mix of leaves and pine needles interspersed with wood ashes and some other organic amendments, as well as green material free of seeds and pests go into this. All these leaves were collected from the property. So a lot of nurseries will shelter their plants under plastic for the wintertime. I shelter my plants under pine needles and leaves. I basically just bury the pots all winter long under that. And that's a lot of leaves and a lot of pine needles. So in the spring, when I gather that stuff up, I have a huge, huge pile of leaves and pine needles. Put them in here, compost them down, and then that goes into the soil mixes. And again, because the leaves have come here, from here, I know they're free of weed seeds. The composting process usually destroys everything else. And you get really good material. And also, since we're here, you can see also, this is pine bark in its raw form before it's processed. And getting good bark, quality bark, is actually kind of a problem. So this material could be passed through a wood chipper to make it finer. And that's where that material comes from. Some invasive plants can change the chemistry of the soil. That goes for a lot of non-native trees also. And even native ones to some extent. So a lot of people are familiar with black walnuts and how black walnut leaves and roots and things are toxic to certain kinds of plants. Well, Norway maple leaves are similar. So you wouldn't want to have your compost be full of black walnut or Norway maple leaves necessarily, because those components actually take a really long time to biodegrade. So if you actually get a municipal source of your leaves for compost, it could have particularly a Norway maple, which is a popular urban street tree. And that does not make great compost.